Hi, it's Dina. I had my camera running when I created this underwater background scene, and I know these types of scenes can be intimidating, so I thought I would share my process and hopefully it will be helpful. A Colorful Life Designs is a brand new series of scenic stencils. These are two-part stencils, so you get the positive and negative for each element. So there are multiple ways you can use each piece, and then infinite ways to combine them into scenes. My paper here is 5x12 because it's going to be used for a specific card design that needs a front panel and a full inside panel. I wanted those two to match. I want to mask off the foreground first. So I've got this Simple Hill Edger number 2 set, and these do fit together, but they also can set side by side to create a continuous curve. So I tape both panels together and then tape them in place so I can focus on my background first. I started by just lightly brushing the background with light blue ink and then added some darker blue in. And at this stage, I'm not really concerned about an even blend. I just want to have some color on my card to provide a base for the other colors. It gives more continuity to this type of scene and it helps the other layers blend together a little bit so the colors aren't so stark against each other. You wouldn't do this for every scene, but in an underwater scene where the colors are going to be a little more murky, it's a good start. The first stencil I'm going to use for my scene is this underwater edger, and this one has plants that are a little larger than the other one that I'm going to use, so I wanted it more to the forefront. This piece of the stencil gives me the positive image of the ocean floor, so that's why I chose this one here. I've got my olive green ink here, and I'm going to work along the edge of the hill stencil and sort of follow the curve. And when I get to the end of the design, I let my ink fade out so I can shift the stencil over and keep the inking even. I don't want a hard edge there because I want my next inking to blend into the previous one. So I move the stencil over and just work in small sections so I can follow the curve of the foreground and create my first layer there. With this next underwater edger, I'm creating another layer behind the first one. And I didn't mask here because I'm using the same color and going actually a little bit lighter. But if I wanted to keep sharp lines and use a contrasting color for this layer, I could mask off the first row with the other side of that stencil, and that would protect those little plants. This layer of the scene is a little further away into the murky water, so I'm not worried about contrast. And I'm just brushing lightly at the top of the open space to create a light row of plants, so I'm not worried about going into my other inking. But again, here I'm shifting my stencil along the panel, connecting the design all the way across. And since these are 6-inch stencils, I love that they have the open ends like this, so that you can use them on longer panels, and they will be great for slimline cards as well. The next layer is done with a mountain edger, and I've got the negative side of my underwater stencil in place, but I don't have anything holding it down except my hand, and so it's tending to shift. Our air conditioner has been out for a few days, and I'm sticking to everything. So I just abandoned that eventually, and the other mountains are taller anyway, so I didn't need to worry about overlap. The last layer of the background is this canyon edger, and again, I didn't worry about masking on this layer because the color is light and those mountains are further away. I pulled the hill stencils away so I can work on the foreground now. And miraculously, that curve can flip the other way to protect my background instead. I didn't need to make any adjustments. And the tape did stick a little bit too much on the back of the paper. So instead of taping my stencils to my inked surface at the top there, I'm just wrapping my tape around to the back. And now I'm ready to ink the foreground. This is called a simple ground edger, so it's got a nice organic edge to it rather than that nice smooth curve. And I don't have a reason for using this brush other than I can't find either of my other yellow ones, but I do like this style of brush for larger areas. Scrapbook.com carries them, and you can also find them on Amazon, and they're called sash brushes. I will link those below. I created one little dune here. Or do they call them dunes underwater? I have no idea. And then some smaller ones in front of that one. And now I'm going to use the mask from that set to cover the foreground so I can fill in the other area between the masks. And finally, you can see how the stencil pieces work together using the positive and negative for layering and contrast. I added a little shading over both sections with the brown ink, and then I decided to warm up the brown a little bit with the yellow ink that was left in my brush. So that was it for the foreground. I can remove my mask, and there is the full landscape altogether. I've got this school of fish that I want to repeat across the panel so we don't forget that we're underwater. And I didn't do anything special with the fish. I just straight inked them and repeated the design across the panel. This design has a nice curve to it and it really repeats nicely. I wanted to add some rays at the top, but not across the full 12-inch panel. So I cut the pieces I needed for the front and inside of my card design. This big raised stencil is 6 inches by 9 inches, so I can use it this way on my front piece and the other way on my inside piece, which is 5 by 8. I'm switching over to my Misty for stenciling, so I can use that strong bar magnet to keep my stencil in place. My stencil also had a little yellow ink on it from the last use, so we're going to pretend that we wanted that to be a little bit green toward the top. The next bit of stenciling is done really loosely. This turbulent water stencil is amazing for water texture, and you can see that I'm not concerned about it staying in place at all. I'm just pulling ink in from the side to create a ripply texture in that area. And the more that stencil moves around, the better it seems for the texture that that creates. My camera battery rudely died at this point, but I used the same techniques to finish off the other panel. And here are both panels together so you can see them at once. This would be a great way to design three card fronts at once if you were wanting to save a little time that way. This is the card that I made with the panels, and that is featured in a tutorial for Split Coast Stampers that I will link below the video. If you would like to learn more about the stencils I used, I would be happy for you to use my affiliate link to check them out. And if you decide to make a purchase, please do use my coupon code for 10% off your order. If you love all the scene stencils, you can get them in a bundle at a 20% discount, so check that Master Creator bundle out as well. If you have questions about the stencils or requests for other demos, let me know down below. Thank you so much for watching.